professional today?
Thank you.
Everything that was surrounding the game, how professional performance was that?
Top. Top performance from everybody involved. Really good. Like the game. It's a difficult game. You play against an opponent. Obviously, it's going for counter attacks, which is absolutely fine, 4-5-1. So we have to get used to it with all, on all accounts. It's like just, we could have, we told the boys in halftime anyway, we could have passed with a bit more purpose, a bit more direction, a bit quicker in moments, but it's difficult. I saw one or two diagonals we tried, which were good, but then through the wind didn't arrive and then we didn't do it anymore. That makes not too much sense. Scored anyway two goals. Wonderful, conceded a set piece goal, which was well executed. We could have done better in that situation for sure, but anyhow, and then you're saying that it's clear when you're as dominant as we are, it's clear that if you keep being dominant, if you and improve in some departments, you will create more chances. What was it? Ostiogo was the third goal, right? This wonderful half volley, blah blah blah. After that was the direction you needed. It was a difficult ball for the defender to defend, I would say. And then we could score there. Yeah. And then another screamer from Norwich, and we could finish the game off. All good. Could bring the boys back. Could give them minutes, which is very helpful. The kids showed up, were involved in 4 out of 5 goals. That's great. So actually, nothing really to complain.
Can I ask how it was from a personal point of view as well, emotionally?
Yeah, it is, but my job is to, I have them, okay, it's not always easy, but I have to put myself together and don't get, but I received all the messages the people send. I'm not made of wood, and so I get all these. I said not too long ago, don't sing the song during the game. People obviously stopped already listening to me. That's good. It's fine. We won the game. We scored after that. So superstitious, if ever was, is done as well. A reason for being superstitious in that case, and it was great. But it's the first game after that, and I'm not here to tell the people what they have to do. It's just we play on Wednesday again, and if it any could ignore for 95 or 100 minutes that the manager is leaving at the end of the season and just do everything to make it as uncomfortable for Chelsea as possible, that would be great. And I know the people know that as well, and so don't have to say it. But it was a wonderful afternoon in all parts of it.
No. Will?
Yeah, obviously James McCall pulls a new assist, how happy for him I am. Just in terms of it, hasn't he? Your 8 years, is this the strongest you've ever seen in terms of talent that's come out of it?
Yeah, and you don't know a few yet, so maybe you know them, but they were not with us yet on the pitch and stuff like this, but there's a lot to come still, so really there. Today Bobby Clark didn't come on, and I think he did particularly well in the last few games. Trey and Duncey are special as well from the U18s. Kumas. There are a lot of really good players coming up still. So yeah, that's academy is a good moment, I would say, producing wise, and it's wonderful. James is probably would consider himself rather as an eight, but a midfielder probably should do if you don't play your whole life on a six. But he's a smart footballer. He has the necessary aggression, the vision, and all these kind of things that he can play on that position on a six. Did it really well today. And on top of that, a good footballer. I not only saw with the cross for Curtis, but as well in a lot of other moments. It's really nice. Connor. Same, just really good. Kwanzaa, not sure how long we still have to talk about him as an academy graduate. He is, yes, great, but actually he's now settled, I would say. He can still improve, of course, because of the age. But he's an important part of the squad, like they all are. And we wouldn't be where we are if the boys wouldn't have been there. You know, there's no chance. And that's why it's so cool to have them. And it's not about me giving them opportunities, it's about them knocking on the door that I can't ignore it, actually, and that's what they did.
Just check on Alexis' couch as well.
Yeah, Alexis, I would say last game of the season, decider or whatever, he could have played, but in all other games not, because he felt a little bit, and we just said, nah, then I don't want to know more. So that's just it. We gave him a rest. I think he should be ready for Wednesday. What do you think? Very important. Eh? So, and that we could give them minutes. You know, it's really. So Trent and Dombey are not too long out, but I think they would say too long anyway. But Robert was really out for a long time. So, and each minute they can get now is really important. And today that helped as well to share intensity again. Darwin we didn't take off because he played bad or whatever, of course not, so because just the amount of games we played and will play. And then the same with Joey. And I probably forgot who was the other one we took off. I forgot. Lucas, for Trent, but that's how it is. And who did we take off when Trent came on? Winger? Curtis. Yeah, then probably. So, but it's all good. We could share the minutes. That was the most important thing, and could win the game. And now, that's it. Now, in 4 weeks we play the next FA Cup game. So, in between, until then, we play just Premier League, if I'm right. So let's do that and one final. Yeah, and let's do that. Let's make sure we are ready for that, because it's not about the boys are back. It's great, but we played pretty good without them, to be honest. So it's not about who is playing, it's about how we are playing. And we have to make sure that we are the one team. No, Chelsea doesn't want to play against, and Arsenal doesn't want to play against. So let's see what we can do with the players we have now available.